This is for my wife and stepdaughter. It's called Coitus Interruptus. It's 6:45 on a Saturday morning, and we're just awake. Our senses are lazy, except our eyes that meet on the same pillow, they connect. We want connection. So we listen. Nothing. No movement in the next room, no cartoons, no fridge door, no Cocoa Pop crunch. We kiss. She breathes and heaves. I grow and slowly move down her neck. Her scent is tangible, warm, sweet, aching. Everything is switching on. What was that? We're alert like squirrels. Tense, rigid, ears sharp as reeds. I think it's just claws on a scratch post. We're fine. 5 seconds later, we're both naked from the waist down, and I'm lower still, underneath the covers. It's warm, she's warm, and we don't need any further persuasion. But we listen. Still the cat. Still the cat. We plunge beneath the duvet like divers in a cotton lagoon, and I'm moving on top of her, in her, with her, but I'm still listening, and I'm feeling, and it's good. She's so good, the framework creaks loud as a mouse, so I go slower. But I want her so much, and momentum finds its voice. It whispers, it groans, it creaks, the cat scratches, and I strain to hear what I don't want to, but I'm feeling, and it's so good, and I'm a piston now, a steam train, loud and fast, and she's with me, running, speeding towards the station, and we're almost there. Where, what are you doing? We're both squirrels again. Busted, but for the dignity of a duvet. I look at the panic in the face beneath me, and I'm reaching for a lie, but she's quicker. We're having a tickle fight. Genius. It's convincing. She's very good. So good, in fact, that her daughter yells, "Brilliant!" and leaps onto the bed and onto my back, thus pushing me deeper into her mum, who shrieks in what I pray is not delight. I'm trapped in an obscene sandwich between mother and daughter. I am fortune's pervert. Her mother scuttled a tickle off my back before 3 seconds to release myself, but upstick neck and the mission shorts could be anywhere. The tickle was in full swing, so I dive back and defy my dignity. I can see my shorts. I can reach them, but I'm spotted by 8-year-old eyes, so I panic and blow raspberries into her belly. She's laughing, I'm reaching, and I'm pulling shorts on blind with one hand while blowing into a child's belly button. Thus forever destroying the myth that men can multitask. I'm safe now. I lure the child off the bed with Cocoa Puffs. I make coffee, switch on cartoons, and I look at my partner in crime. We smile, we laugh, we connect, and we check the calendar to see when the child is next with her dad.